Saturday morning, about 9:30. Look at all these flags. There's not a single cloud in the sky, just a slight breeze. We are waiting for the start of the third round, juniors, flyoffs, and it will be very interesting to see what they will do. So we have a slight breeze from the south, maybe southeast, and I expect the action to happen across the fields down towards the runway. Two guys went reasonably high, 80 meters plus. Then we have two guys lower behind me on the field on the towards the runway. And then we have a group of four over here. Three are kinda low and one is at a safe height already, scanning the area. This is now directly in the sun. Gunshots you're hearing are from the nearby police school, I'm told. They have a shooting field for practice. Doesn't want to go up, but it's not going down all at the same time, so let's see. pumping the energy rather well, but I think this is not enough to gain height. It's slowly going down. Pity. So everyone else is at safe heights already. The air is completely still, at least here where I'm standing. But I see flags on the corners of the camping area. They are active. So there's one group towards the south, and the other group is towards the runway. Four planes already at safe height to finish the about 9.5 minutes remaining. Okay, so now one from that group to the south decided to join them. Let's see how that turns out. He lost some height crossing the field. He's still hoping to find the lower edge of this thermal somewhere here. Nothing yet. Still nothing. Search the wider area maybe. So the group above him is staying at about the same height, so looks like the thermal has died, or at least it's not strong enough yet to really climb. And the other two that stayed there south of the start line, they are also where they were a few minutes ago, and nothing much is happening. Looks like now they both decided to join the crowd towards the runway. Now we get all the planes in the same spot in the sky. Kinda where I said before start where the action would be. And now it is over the runway. There's one seagull crossing. Not really interested in thermaling. Seagulls are particularly interesting. So they are known to thermal every now and then, but they usually do it in large flocks. So it looks like thermaling for them is more of a social activity than actual flying for hunting. So it's a bit tricky. So if you see a flock of seagulls circling, doesn't necessarily mean that there's a thermal there. About 3.5 minutes remaining. So that guy at the bottom, working for all this time, didn't gain much, but he still he managed to stay in the air. That's another nerve-wracking flight, I guess. It looks like he has enough now, giving up. Just a few minutes remaining. Good job. Minutes to go. Now the remaining, what, 6 planes are coming back. 1 minute to go. Pretty high. Seconds. Okay, now let's wait for the final start. Waiting for the last start of the juniors. Flags are doing nothing much. So just a minute ago we had a slight breeze from the southeast, which makes me think that it will now be interesting to fly towards the corner of the field, towards the northwest. But no idea how fast these thermals are rolling across the ground. Since there isn't much wind, I would say it's still worth to try and catch this thermal. It didn't move far yet. So looks like our juniors read the sky in the same way as I did. All of them are now towards the northwest. So let's see if we got this right. So four of them are low and at least two started reasonably high, just for a safe flight of 15 minutes. Which is probably interesting strategy. I mean, the challenge now here is what is the lowest height from which you can make full flight without that low height giving you, or without that height giving you penalty that you don't score well. I mean, we still only have four flights in these flyoffs, and based on the amount of risk people are taking, I would say just make four sure flights. So you don't need to be the lowest. Just make sure that you do full 15 minutes, and that will give you a reasonably good standing in the score. For example, our team, Slovenian, they got a third place in team rankings, and that was just by flying steadily and ensuring that they get a good result without risking too much. looks interesting now. They're organized in like two layers. So the lower four are kind of climbing slowly, but the upper four, they lost height. Which is very interesting. So I would read this as if the upper four are too much directly above the lower four, but they should be further downwind. So they are circling in front of the thermal, not in the thermal. Ten minutes to go, and looks like this time all will make it. The breeze has now increased slightly, which I would say is a good news for them. It's still in my back, so it's blowing towards them. Means the air is getting more active where they are. Nothing else to do now but wait for the time to pass.
5 minutes to go. So this flight could be qualified as boring. So at this point I would stop thermaling and would just fly straight across the sky out of the crowd, find an empty place in the sky as to spend the remaining time there. Looks like that's exactly what our juniors are doing. Minutes to go. Now it's time to lose height.
Okay. Well done, everyone. Let's see what the results are.